Пока на нас, да?
Да.
Не пока, и вообще камеры.
Вообще, да, вообще камеры для нас не существуют.
О, супер, слава.
Да, мы тут сидим, шампанское пьем.
Дайте, пожалуйста, мне.
Давайте,
cheers.
Спасибо тебе, что пришла.
Спасибо, что позвали. I have to change to English, right? The mood into English. A bit weird.
Hello, dear viewers. Hope you are doing well today. And if not, if you feel a little bit sad, no worries, because we're gonna cheer you up with our next guest. Beautiful woman, top professional Latin dancer, mother, wife, and I can continue so on and on and on. Please welcome Victoria Horeva. Victoria, hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good morning. I feel great, but a little bit ooh.
Everyone coming with the nervous.
Somehow everyone is afraid to come. Everybody has this a little bit feeling.
Because you never know what you're gonna ask, right?
Yeah, and more now that we don't have competitions yet, this adrenaline, this excitement, we are missing it in our life. So we actually decided also because of that to give our dancers a little bit some adrenaline, excitement. Okay, dear, we're gonna start our interview with first question. Who are you? Can you describe yourself to our viewers?
Who am I? First of all, I think I'm a very kind person and very peaceful. Very peaceful. I like peace. I like everything to be nice around me, calm. That's who I am. But inside all of that, okay, I could say I'm a peaceful warrior. Okay. Yeah, I would say I like to never give up. That probably, yeah.
Nice. And we actually don't ask this question usually. We don't like it, but because we don't know about you, and we wanted to ask you, how actually did you start to dance? In which country? What age?
I was born in Latvia in a small city named Daugavpils. Okay. And actually, I started from ballet. Yeah, at the age of 5. And then I switched to tennis because my daddy wanted me to be a superstar in tennis. Yeah, and then one day I could win Wimbledon. But then one day my mom came to, you know, to the training, to the tennis training, and I was playing like, don't think the posture was not that great anymore. And then she said, I don't think that's a good idea for you to continue tennis. Let's look for something else. And then dancing. Do you want to go dancing? Say, let me take a look. And we went to just actually see what is this dancing. And say, yeah, okay, I will go there. And that's how my dancing career started.
So it was more your mom who directed you into that?
It was mom who said we need to do something else.
Yeah.
And then actually my grandma took me to see what is actually dancing.
What is actually this something else?
Yeah, something else.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what age you were when you started?
I was around 10.
Okay.
Yeah.
Young enough.
Yeah.
We asked this question to your husband.
Okay.
And we wanted to ask you as well. So the question was, who are you for him? Yes. And he needed to put an order of the... how to say, preference.
Not the preference, but meaning for him. Value, how he sees you.
Can you put in the order of who is Victoria for you? So, you have woman, dance partner, wife, mother of your kid, friend, lover.
She's my partner in crime, I would call. I see it as a journey of what we most people call life, and I chose her to be my partner. So, and together we go through different situations. So it's like a team. team that is willing to whatever comes across to conquer it.
So I want to ask the same questions, but who are you for yourself? Put it in the order. You have woman, dancer, wife, mother, competitor, artist.
For him.
For you.
For you.
For me, for myself.
For, you
for yourself.
Understood. Okay. We found yes. out already.
Ah, okay.
What would you put first, second, and third, maybe? As you are now, in your stage of life.
I think I'm still a woman, number one. And then it would be artist. And then a mother. And then wife.
Okay, and what about competitor?
Where in all of them?
Competitor is resting at the moment, right? So maybe when it all begins again, maybe it will change.
Actually, surprising that you put artist on the second place for me.
Really, me as well.
Yeah. So that's why I wanted to ask how, why artist now on the second place?
And should be what first?
Not should be.
It's not how it
is you, for how you it thought. Is not
yeah.
No. Your thought is.
I don't know. Maybe a wife or mother.
I think because, as you know, like it's a break from competitive, actually life, and then even during this period, I think we are very much like into this practice and developing new style, new stuff. Like it's the work is going on, so I feel like. Very artistic now in this period of time.
Okay. So we catch you in this moment.
Yes.
That's, okay.
Yes.
And the way you said, first of all, you are the woman, and also for me, for example, this is also how I see you always in the studio. You have this vibe, really feminine from you. Who is man for such a woman as you are? In your perfect world, how would you describe a male figure, a male creature, who he is?
Gentleman. For sure, I must be a gentleman who takes care of me, who adores me, who brings me flowers, champagne.
We take one. Okay, where is the flowers?
Yeah, but generally somebody who takes care of you.
Yeah, definitely.
And as you see yourself as a personality and as human being, do you feel you accomplished the character that you would like and you wanted to be, or you are still in the process, or you are in the constant process? How it's
yeah I feel maybe it's a constant process of developing and yeah creating something new and achieving something new and keep developing it. Yeah, so it's still in a search, I would say.
So as a personality, what you are searching for?
I'm searching. Okay, at the moment I tell you, my challenge is really to give interviews to others. Yeah, basically public speaking and like talking is my new challenge. If you ask me, would you choose to dance and like perform and compete and do the show or competition or talk? I would say definitely for me it's much easier to go and just do it, deliver it, dance. And then to speak is, I'm still learning.
It's
challenging.
For us too.
Yeah. But you know, I know for sure for Sharunas, he must be like, the talk is his, the king of the talk, I'm pretty sure.
Really? Well, he looked like he was enjoying the talk, actually.
Yes. Yeah.
I think so.
And then as a dancer, do you feel like you already accomplished yourself and you finished the character that you would like to bring to the floor, or it's also the time in the search?
No way, it still keeps going, and then you know it keeps going on and on, and you think you're so many years in dancing, you should have been like already clear, right?
So what is it that you're searching for as a dancer right now?
It's kind of, you know, you always want to be yourself. Like I always wanted to be myself and to be able to show my instincts on the dancing floor in that moment in time to that music playing, like really to be so real for yourself. This is the challenge, the number one challenge. But on the other side, you also want to achieve some You also could be an actor, right? So somewhere you could play some drama, something else. So, and then at the moment I'm between these two. So where I could actually play it, mm-hmm. and then when I want to be real and how to do it in the best manner.
Do you think it's a good thing to be real always on the floor?
Before I used to think that you have to be real and once you're real, that's it. Mm-hmm. But at this moment in time, like I found maybe, you know, always real is a good idea, but you could add some sparkles in it, you know, what maybe is not so natural for you in a daily life.
And can I ask one more additional question? Because you said first, I'm a woman.
Yes.
For you, which quality should have woman to call herself woman? Hmm. Because for everyone is different definition woman, how she should be, for example, right? So for you, what is it?
I think it's grace, elegance, and then personal qualities would be first is self-respect and then respecting others as well. And of course, taking care as a woman and as a mother, as a wife. It's kind of all in one, I think, it's a whole package.
And then, for example, your daughter grows,
yeah.
and you see her transforming from a little child to girl, to the lady, and then very soon she will also become a woman. As a woman, which female qualities you as mother would like to see in her later on? For sure it's care, for sure it's grace, but do you have something particular that you really would like your daughter to have for her life?
I really want her to be a warrior, that she would never give up and she could keep going and then achieve whatever she likes. So, yeah, and to keep her goal.
Now you encourage a little bit of that character.
Yes, for sure. Big time. Yes.
Lovely. That's good experience from mom to know that actually, she's standing behind your back and pushing you like, come on, come on.
No, and for sure you are like example, right? I think for to be a parent, first you need to be example for the kid. Not saying or not showing, but being example. So I think you're doing great in this case. And what would you tell to your 18 years old self? If you will meet now Victoria of 18 years old, what would you tell her?
Let me think. 18, we just started to dance with Sharunas, you know? It was exactly the age of 18 when it all started. So I don't know, the journey just started then.
So maybe 17, maybe 20, I don't know. When was that moment that you would give some advice, maybe?
Okay, yeah, before that.
Ask something.
Probably before that, I would just say, keep working hard because the hard work always will pay off. Just keep doing. Yeah, that's my motto, I think, of my life.
Do you feel at your stage now in your life that this work that you made through your career, through your life, did it pay off or still not? Or not yet?
I think it's paying off slowly but surely. slowly.
Okay, very good.
We need to make a little break.
Okay.
Yeah. Non gay?
Да. Я like у меня к тебе вопрос. Почему вот это? А где два? Вот это два? Или вот это два? Я чуть-чуть запуталась.
Что два? Я не помню, что ты спрашиваешь.
Что-то будет сейчас. Сейчас что-то будет.
Okay, so we have to start the interview to bring a little bit more spice straight away because for now it's everything very nice and yeah. sweet. We need a little bit of spice. We always play games with the guests who are coming, and for you it will be something about photos. So with different people, we discuss different things, and because you said you are in the constant research of yourself as a dancer and as a female, we would like to ask you about your looks throughout your competitive career. Okay. Because you are very known to be quite changeable.
Yeah, really?
Yeah, like, let's say changeable, not about the dresses, but you are very brave to experiment with the hair. And this is what we would like to see, your reaction to that. On my opinion, that was really, really beautiful.
This is Blackpool, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
Blackpool. That's Blackpool.
Actually,
Sharuna's actually has black hair there. And you are blonde, so this is before or after the previous picture?
After, is way after, right? After. This is our amateur days. I think this is our last amateur competition, actually. The very last one, before we turn professional.
Okay.
Yeah.
I remember this is the first comp that I saw on the recording video when I knew Sharuna and Victoria for
really?
The first time. This, yeah, this.
Well, you look this so look and beautiful, this hair. Like so.
I remember who is this couple are doing so nice crusada walks. I remember they were showing you in Samba, I think. I was like, wow, so good. Who are they? I don't know them. I remember this.
Okay, then you turn to pro.
Yes.
Yep. And I'm not sure if it's the turning point or not, but tell me how that happened.
Oh, okay. That then you will like it. That was a drama, a big drama.
Really?
for me to turn red, and actually, as you can see, is much shorter hair.
Yes.
Much shorter.
Yes.
So actually it was my teachers who encouraged me to change the style, to change the image. Yeah.
Okay.
So actually that year we were going for Pro Rising Star.
And I remember it correct. Yeah.
Yes, it was Pro Rising Star, and then okay, we have to come out and be bang on, right? So and then it was the actual preparation for Blackpool already, like on the way towards it. And just a week before, so the competition, so I went to this hairdresser, advised by my teachers, and then, okay, we said we want this and that, and it has to be this extreme look, you know,
yes.
With us it's always extreme.
That's what I'm trying to bring up here. Yeah.
And then at that time I had blonde, nice and blonde hair, yeah, like the usual one, the one you already remember me
yeah.
with. So and then she's coloring it to red, okay, still okay, I'm okay. And then she's cutting it shorter and it's almost like spiky. And then I look at myself to the mirror and I'm crying, the tears just going, like, ah, what's that? You know, so then I come out of this, so, and I don't know how to style it, it's just like standing. So once you wake up and wash your hair, what to do with that? So, and then I just, you know, style it back with gel it back and do something. And then it was quite a challenge also for the daily life.
Mm-hmm.
But then actually, I think it was Maria who did my hair for that competition. And then actually she styled it so nicely. And actually, I really loved that look on the competition floor with that dress, with that routines that we had that time. Mm-hmm. It was actually, I really liked myself.
So it was challenging in the beginning, but then once you
yes.
are watching back, you like it.
Yeah, but then after the competition again on a daily life, it was like,
okay. You didn't feel yourself, yeah? For this specific day, it was good, but then...
Yeah. Because once it's styled and it's really there in that character, it really, yeah, it's cool.
And then you went...
Wow, you changed so many times.
Even more red. Like for Blackpool you felt stressed and then even more red. How that was?
I think this is actually the same red, just less gel.
Okay.
So and it's a little bit longer hair already. This is the first competition after Gabi was born.
Okay.
Yeah, so it was also trying something new but already less gel.
But it looks to me it looks totally different. With the gel it was one
yes.
one type of character, and this is totally different woman.
Different.
Yeah.
How about Sarunas? Which wiki he likes the most?
I think you know he's type of the person that he likes changes. So and it wouldn't be like I like that or that. he likes the process of changing, to see that it's not one and the same thing, not stuck.
Oh, I have new wife, so good. Thank you.
Okay, and then time goes by, and we have this you. Uh-huh. This is later already, right? After that red hair or before?
Yes, yes, this is later.
This is the latest one. No?
So with this dress, who came up the idea? That basically you have the free hair and very short, loose, almost like a nightgown.
That was also a very interesting story for me. It was actually, this is my top from daily life. I came, I think, to some event. It was like some restaurant or some celebration, and I was wearing this top, just like, you know, with leggings. And then my teacher said, "This will be a nice dress for your next competition." And then, of course, we brought it to the tailor and then put some stones here and there, a little of the beads, and this is what you see. That's it, yeah.
Amazing. Amazing.
Break?
Break.
Break. Окей.
Ну что, не сильно мы тебя мучаем?
Нет.
Ну все. Вот, видишь? Мы хорошие девочки.
So, switching off from this fun and nice and sweet mode,
let's fashion go rubric.
Let's go a little bit deeper, because there are some very serious also topics that we would like to bring, and we would like to know your opinion as a grown-up woman already about these things. So probably somebody young who is listening to it, that will be some clue of how to face some situations that they are passing through in their dancing career. So how would you describe who is victim for you? Like, when you see somebody and you sense that there is this mentality of the victim, how would you describe this person? You know why I'm asking? Maybe that will help you to answer as well the question. Because I think all of us, like, it goes without saying that all of us, at certain point in our dancing life and generally life, we are all as human beings facing some difficult situations. And it's our choice how to act inside that situation and how to treat that situation and how to make yourself feel about it. Like, for sure it gives you the feeling, but then your attitude towards the feeling, you can choose how you're reacting. So I think when we are in that difficult stage, it's very easy to fall into the habit of allowing other people telling you something or dictating you what to do. And just because we are trying to be soft and nice and feminine and kind-hearted and good people, we can easily allow ourselves into something that calls of feeling being a victim of a situation and not taking enough responsibilities for your actions or for your decisions or even for the way you see or understand things. So how would you, what are your thoughts about it?
I feel it's a little bit like weak people who play a victim role, you know, like as we always say, don't be a victim, be a victor, be in control of your own destiny, of your own life, take your own decision and feel responsible about this. Don't play a victim, it's just for weak.
So this play a victim, what it means for you?
Feel sorry for yourself, like feel like very, oh, poor me, like how did it happen to me, why did it happen to me, like all of this.
And where is this border in between listening to the other person? I'm not talking about partner even. It can be anybody. It can be friend, can be husband, can be teacher.
Mother.
Can be mother.
Father. Yeah. Because you respect so much a person and you would like to be loved and to love, but you still have this different opinion maybe or different principles to stand for.
Yeah. And where is this border in between giving the respect and understanding and allowing the other person to have his or her opinion, but at the same time stick for your principles and not allowing yourself to fall into something that you are not?
Yeah, actually, I really think it's so important to stick to your own principles, because you will be always criticized and advised so many things, this and that, you know, like all these Instagram quotes. If you are fat, they say you are too fat. So if you are thin, they say you are too thin and whatever. So I really believe that you have to trust your instincts, your heart, and follow that. Of course, listen to advice, but then to stay true to your own self, I think this is the most difficult and the most important for me.
And how to find this, stay true to yourself? Because we hear it quite often, and I, you know why I'm asking? Not to push you to talk about this, because I really want to bring up something. I would like that we discuss these deep things, so for somebody who is maybe facing that, knows what exactly to do. Because how you said in Instagram, there is a lot of very wise quotes, but then what you actually need to do with this quote?
I think it's like truly listen deep inside what your heart is saying. It's like, you know, even if like really advice, like the technical advice, what to do. You sit down in a quiet room, close your eyes, and stay for a while, like maybe some quiet music or something in the room for the atmosphere. And you close and you maybe ask a question, what is like really is interesting for you, and then you sit there and the answer will come. But you just have to allow yourself some time to really listen what's happening, and then you will know for sure if it's the right answer or not. Like what you should follow, this or that, you will know. Your heart will tell me. Tell you.
And then how to find that line in between being warm towards the other people, but at the same time sticking to your own truth?
Oh, of course, you always have to still respect, and you say thank you for your advice, and I really admire your advice, and I like it, but maybe this time I stick to mine. Yeah, or if you really like that, why not to take somebody's advice?
This is so polite answer.
Yes.
I'm sorry, your advice is so nice, but this back basic, I'm gonna do my way, darling.
Would you do it that way for yourself?
I need to learn that. Can I have a lesson?
No, I would do like this, if about the back basic. I would really try the suggested way, because you never know.
I'm just joking.
You just really try. But then if you still don't like it, you would go back to your own.
No, but I'm really admire, because sometimes when I have my vision, I'm telling for myself, for my opinion, it's so hard to see others.
Right.
You know what I mean? So that's what I think
we are trying to bring up.
Yes.
Right.
Yes, from both sides. Yeah, the one who is maybe want to say something to you, and the one who is listening.
Who is listening?
Yeah.
Who need to take the thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm learning to try it all, so not to be, you know, closed-minded that no, it's only mine and that's it, although I think it's very important, but some advice is still sometimes very useful. So I would really try it, and then I'll decide for myself which one.
Okay, so it's on a daily basis, generally. We all are dealing with this. You cannot really find the magical pill.
No magic.
Okay.
Okay, dear, to go a little bit in the beginning of your dancing career, why are you dancing?
I feel in dancing all the problems, all the everything just disappears. You just go into another bubble and you live in that another world, where you submerge, and then that's it, you are there. So it's just different, it's not our reality. Even during this COVID times, once you dance, it's just another world.
Do you feel the same on practice field and on the competition?
I always prefer competitions. I really love competitions.
Really?
Yeah, because nobody can tell me during the competition, oh, you're not doing this right, oh, you're not doing this and that. I just do it and I deliver my way. So there is no chance for extra talking. So you just do it. Yeah, but actually, maybe you will be interested in that, why I'm dancing. A long time ago, like again, back to my childhood, I was still that time playing tennis. And you know, that time it was very popular to go to some astrologist or like some people like that, where they will look into your, I don't know, information. I think it was about astrology. Yeah, I think that was that. And the man actually was very good. So, and then he said, well, I think she definitely, like your daughter, he was talking to my mom, mm-hmm. said, I think your daughter will definitely have success in a sport related to the beauty. And that time I was playing tennis, and my parents, tennis, very beautiful sport. But then, like, just I think maybe half a year later, I went to dancing. Mm-hmm. And then later and later, and then already maybe first places started to appear. And then my parents, I think we found one. What is the sport related to the beauty? I think that's the one.
And as a dancer, how do you feel yourself? What is your input into the partnership?
I'm, as I said, I'm a warrior. So I would really push to deliver. Like whatever we plan to do, to deliver. Not like a little bit like this, maybe like that. No, you decided, you do it.
So you feel yourself more artist or competitor, if it's like that?
Artistic competitor.
Okay, that's a good explanation.
Yeah, I think competitor is a little bit stronger because I really push for delivering it. Mm-hmm. And no matter what, I want to deliver. Yeah, that's my, I don't know, I feel very satisfied once it's delivered.
Do you always stick to the plan? You don't like to improvise? That's because how it sounded, you are really, okay, we plan this, we do it. Yeah.
That's another challenge of my life. I have my lovely husband and partner who is very artistic and creative, and he is always changing the plans. So
I so understand you.
I feel like it's me talking now.
Yeah, so you would know, right? So yeah, I love planning, but a lot of times I just don't go with my planning. So I also learn how to readjust and to be flexible with that. And I think it's also a very useful skill.
Or do you like when it's
the profession, I think, to be readjustable in the moment and time.
Yes.
And still not to look like something.
Yeah,
like
then it's still the product is good.
That's the
point. But do you afraid or are you afraid when because I like I'm also very planning, and if someone change my plan, I'm just get crazy.
We know.
And so I'm really stressed about it. So if I practice so many times this thing like that, why I should do different in competition? You know. So are you not afraid that because I feel fear if I change it, I might not look good as how I did it before, right? So are you afraid to change it?
Sometimes. Yeah.
So when Saruna's changing it?
Yes, big time.
Yes. How you deal with this fear?
Yeah. How I deal? I talk to myself.
Oh, wow.
I really
deal with it.
Deal with that. And do it. No, I talk. What do I say? I say, because you know, I think I still have this artistic side and kind of natural and instincts. Yeah, so I said, okay, as long as this is like a natural reaction, so it's not that you change and you do how I said like this and is another way and I really don't like it, then it's like, I don't want to do it. Yeah, but then if it's spontaneously something done and then I have to naturally react, then actually, that's nice. Yeah, but like through the playing, then okay. That would do.
And talking about the plan, because Sarunas mentioned, because he also had this nonsense photo, and we were talking about your Paso Doble. Okay. And we know that you had three or even more endings.
But sometimes we would have few endings, you know. So nice. Sometimes we have the choreography that sometimes can change to another choreography. So it's not necessary always the same choreography. So, and then what I do is that when it's appropriate for the moment and when the body is in a state where you're no longer really thinking, then the body does whatever ending it chooses to do in that particular moment in time.
So as a partner, how did you know that he's gonna do second one and not the first and third, for example? Because I feel, for me, it's a thing that you learn through many years. It's not coming up after 1 year of partnership, of 2 years of partnership, even 5.
Yeah.
How was it for you? And how do you know what he's gonna do?
Or you don't know.
Or you don't know and you just, yeah.
Second.
Sometimes I really don't know what he's going to do. Like, well, we have the options, as you said, right? But then what will happen at the end, I really don't know.
I changed the whole second part. It was just wrong to do the original. And I remember Vicky also after that saying, and she's going from behind and thinking, like, what are you doing, you know?
So, and it's a really, as I say, a natural reaction, what's happening right now in that moment in time. So and then you just respond, okay, we're falling, boom, I'm there.
That's exciting, right? Amazing. Okay, now I'm falling. Okay, now I jump. Let's run.
That's exactly. You're laughing, but this is exactly what's happening.
But it's exciting, I think. Then no competition is boring.
Yeah, I tell you, like every time we plan something, yeah, and actually it was just okay-ish competitions, but every time it was like created on the spot, I think that was always the best results. Yeah, and the best feeling of, yeah.
Do you think it has something to do with the energy that you produce at this moment? Because like, you don't know what is happening. Sharunas hopefully knows, probably knows, I don't know, but
he also said that sometimes he doesn't even know what he's going to do.
He's very much on the instinct. So yes. You both are very much on the edge of emotion at this moment. Mm-hmm. Do you think people connect to that and that's why it becomes successful? Or what, why, how would you...
What connects people?
People connect to this real emotion that you both are producing at mm-hmm. this moment. Mm-hmm. Because there should be some explanation why something that is
just came up
the moment just came up becomes more successful than something that you really take time to do.
Yeah, I really believe in energy around you, the atmosphere what you create around your couple, around yourself, and then it definitely attracts other people. Like the vibe is different. Mm-hmm. Yeah, once you're planning and preset things, yeah, is one like a little bit stuck, stiff feeling. Yeah, and then once it's like, whoa, spontaneous, I think it's straight away like, whoa, nice.
Ah, so it gives you also this excitement.
Yeah.
I think this feeling of alive, you know,
yeah.
Alive, yes, that's yeah. What also makes, gives emotions to the people because they can see it's alive. It's not something that you did for 100 times. And then like 100, okay, one more time.
For sure. And then if you both like so much this feeling of excitement and artistry behind it, mm-hmm. why do you allow to your teachers to plan your looks? Because you said a lot of looks of yours were inspired by the teachers, like they were the ones.
But I think they are more like inspiration, playing like inspirational role, mm-hmm. yeah, and like advice, which we really believe, you know, in that. And then it actually feels good that somebody is really like thinking of you, takes mm-hmm. care of you, suggesting something, and then you take it.
Yeah. And you never had the feeling that if you trust so much, you try, mm-hmm. it was not purely your decision, you try, it doesn't work, you will always regret. You never had this.
I didn't have this experience, like even with this red hair, it was like so dramatic for me, but then at the end I still loved it. And also, yeah, and it was very successful. So I think it was a great decision. Although for me it was a bit tough.
But before that, you never feel fear that you might be regret afterwards.
No, it's okay. You know, you still can choose. After that, you can do another one.
Okay.
And it will be changing. So never regret, just try. Go for it.